wonder if I've got any beet seeds. Oh, here's church.
Rendition of Never Walk Alone. The song rushed to the very top of the charts and now captured the oldest artist ever to hold.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Good morning.
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 Good morning. Good to see you, Margot.
Did anybody hear that? Because I think maybe I wasn't sharing the audio. Did anybody hear that?
No, music heard.
Oh, well, let me do it again.
Yay.
Is that okay?
Of course it is.
Yes.
All right, here we go. It's just 2 minutes.
Good morning. It's good to have you here this morning to worship with us. Let us begin. Hallelujah. Christ is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed. Hallelujah. Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. God of all mercy, we confess that we have sinned against you, opposing your will in our lives. We have denied your goodness in each other, in ourselves, and in the world you have created. We repent of the evil that enslaves us, the evil we have done, and the evil done on your behalf. Forgive, restore, and strengthen us through our Savior Jesus Christ, that we may abide in your love and serve only your will. Amen.
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 May Almighty God have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen. Amen.
Lord, open our lips.
And our mouths shall proclaim your praise.
Glory to
the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. The Lord is risen indeed. Come, let us adore him.
Let us adore him.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Christ, our Passover. I will read it responsively and respond at the half verse. Alleluia, Christ, our Passover has been sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the feast.
Not with the leaven of malice and evil.
But with the unleavened bread
of sincerity and truth.
Hallelujah.
Christ, being raised from the dead, will never die again.
Death no longer has dominion over him.
The death that he died to sin once for all.
But the life he lives to God.
So consider yourselves dead to sin.
And alive to God in Jesus Christ our Lord. Hallelujah.
Christ has been raised from the dead.
The first fruits of those who have fallen asleep.
For since by a man came death.
By a man has come also the resurrection of the dead.
For as in Adam all die.
So also in Christ all shall be alive. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Psalm appointed is Psalm 116. I love the Lord because he has heard the voice of my supplication.
Because he has inclined his ear to me whenever I called upon him.
The cords of death entangled me. The grip of the grave took hold of me.
I came to grief and sorrow.
Then I called upon the name of the Lord.
O Lord, I pray you, save my life.
How shall I repay the Lord?
For all the good things he has done for me.
I will lift up the cup of salvation.
And call upon the name of the Lord.
I will fulfill my vows to the Lord.
In the presence of all his people.
Precious in the sight of the Lord.
Is the death of his servants.
O Lord, I am your servant.
I am your servant and the child of your handmaid. You have freed me from my bonds.
I will offer you the sacrifice of thanksgiving.
And call upon the name of the Lord.
I will fulfill my vows to the Lord.
In the presence of all his people.
In the courts of the Lord's house.
In the midst of you, O Jerusalem, hallelujah. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Hallelujah.
The first reading is from the book of Acts. Peter, standing with the 11, raised his voice and addressed the crowd. Therefore, let the entire house of Israel know with certainty that God made him both Lord and Messiah, this Jesus whom you crucified. Now, when they heard this, they were cut to the heart and said to Peter and to the other apostles, Brothers, what should we do? Peter said to them, Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Christ Jesus Christ, so that your sins may be forgiven. And you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. For the promise is for you, for your children, and for all who are far away, everyone whom the Lord our God calls to him. And he testified with many other arguments and exhorted them, saying, Save yourselves from this corrupt generation. So those who welcomed his message were baptized, and that day about 3,000 persons were added. Hear what the Spirit is saying to the church.
Thanks be to God.
God.
Worthy of praise, glory to you.
Glory to you for the radiance of your holy name.
We will praise you and highly exalt you forever.
Glory to you in the splendor of your temple.
And on the throne of your majesty, glory to you.
Glory to you seated between the cherubim.
We will praise you and highly exalt you forever.
Glory to you beholding the dead.
In the high vault of heaven, glory to you.
Glory to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
We will praise you and highly exalt you forever.
The second reading is from 1 Peter chapter 1. If you invoke as Father the one who judges all people impartially according to their deeds, live in reverent fear during the time of your exile. You know that you are ransomed from the futile ways inherited from your ancestors, not with the perishable things like silver or gold, but with the precious blood of Christ, like that of a lamb without defect or blemish. He was destined before the foundation of the world, but was revealed at the end of the ages for your sake. Through him you have come to trust in God, who raised him from the dead and gave him glory, so that your faith and hope are set on God. Now that you have purified your souls by your obedience to the truth, so that you have genuine mutual love, love one another deeply from the heart. You have been born anew, not of perishable, but of imperishable seed, through the living and enduring word of God. Hear what the Spirit is saying to the church.
Thanks be to God. Canticle 21. We praise you, O God. We acclaim you as Lord. All creation worships you, the Father everlasting. To you, all angels, all the powers of heaven, the cherubim and seraphim sing in endless praise. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. The glorious company of apostles praise you. The noble fellowship of the prophets praise you. The white-robed army of martyrs praise you. Throughout the world, the Holy Church acclaims you, Father of majesty unbounded, your true and only Son, worthy of all worship, and the Holy Spirit, advocate and guide. You, Christ, are the King of glory, the eternal Son of the Father. When you took our flesh to set us free, you humbly chose the Virgin's womb. You overcame the sting of death and opened the kingdom of heaven to all believers. You are seated in God's right hand in glory. We believe that you will come to be our judge. Come then, Lord, and help your people, bought with the price of your own blood. Bring us with your saints to glory everlasting.
Okay, sorry about that.
It happened.
That was another organist, not me. Here we go. Let's sing. Alleluia. Give thanks to the risen one.
Thank you.
Reading from the Gospel of Luke. Now on that same day, two of the disciples were going to a village called Emmaus, about 7 miles from Jerusalem, and talking with each other about all these things that had happened. While they were talking and discussing, Jesus himself came near and went with them. But their eyes were kept from recognizing him. And he said to them, "What are you discussing with each other while you walk along?" They stood still, looking sad. And then one of them, whose name was Cleopas, answered him, "Are you the only stranger in Jerusalem who does not know the things that have taken place there in these days?" He asked them, "What things?" And they replied, "The things about Jesus of Nazareth, who was a prophet, mighty in deed and word before God and all the people, and how our chief priests and leaders handed him over to be condemned to death and crucified him. But we had hoped that he was the one to redeem Israel. Yes, and besides all this, it is now the third day since these things took place. Moreover, some women of our group astounded us. They were at the tomb early this morning, and when they did not find his body there, they came back and told us that they had indeed seen a vision of angels who said that he was alive. Some of those who were with us went to the tomb and found it just as the women had said, but they did not see him. Then he said to them, 'Oh, how foolish you are, and how slow of heart to believe all that the prophets have declared. Was it not necessary that the Messiah should suffer these things and then enter into his glory?' Then, beginning with Moses and all the prophets, he interpreted to them the things about himself in all the scriptures. As they came near the village to which they were going, he walked ahead as if he were going on. But they urged him strongly, saying, 'Stay with us, because it's almost evening and the day is now nearly over.' So he went in to stay with them. And when he was at table with them, he took bread, blessed and broke it, and gave it to them. And then their eyes were opened and they recognized him, and he vanished from their sight. They said to each other, 'Were not our hearts burning within us while he was talking to us on the road, while he was opening the scriptures to us?' That same hour, they got up and returned to Jerusalem, and they found the 11 and their companions gathered together. They were saying, 'The Lord has risen indeed, and he has appeared to Simon.' And then they told what had happened on the road and how he was made known to them in the breaking of the bread. Hear what the Spirit is saying to the church. Thanks be to God."
A 6th century hymn attributed to St. Columba. The path I walk, Christ walks it. Through the land which I find myself be without sorrow. May the Trinity protect me wherever I stay. Bright angels walk with me. The ninefold people of heaven come with me. May I arrive at every place I enter. Well does the fair Lord show us a course and a path. Columba's journey shares some similarities to ours. Columba experienced a pandemic of terrible proportions. The plague of Justinian was a pandemic that afflicted the Byzantine and Holy Roman Empires and a good bit of Europe. Historians believe the plague of Justinian was one of the deadliest pandemics in history, resulting in the deaths of an estimated 100 million people, a death toll equivalent to as much of half as Europe's population. The plague's social and cultural impact has been compared to that of the Black Death of the 14th century. Columba and his peers were on a journey of the unknown during a time of crisis and loss, much like our own journey today with COVID-19, much like the journey of our two apostles on the road to Emmaus. Life is a journey filled with life-changing moments that define who we are. This is certainly true of our gospel story today. And even after spending much of the day with Jesus, the men did not recognize him. Evening was soon approaching and the disciples needed rest, and so they found a place to lodge. And there Jesus sat down at a table. He took bread, blessed it, and broke it. And it was here that the disciples' eyes were opened, and they recognized that the man they had been speaking to on their journey was, in fact, Jesus. This gospel passage clearly indicates that it was at the breaking of bread that the disciples' eyes were opened. Even though they'd walked and talked with him on their journey, they did not experience his fullness until he broke bread with them. Breaking bread is not simply about eating a meal. It's much, much more than that. It is about his body. It signifies the Eucharist, which Jesus instituted at the Last Supper. Remember the words of the gospel? While they were eating, Jesus took bread. He said the blessing. He broke it. And he gave it to them and said, "Take, eat. This is my body." And then he took the cup. He gave thanks and he gave it to them, saying, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed on behalf of many for the forgiveness of sins." This is perhaps the greatest way to experience Christ. You can certainly experience him by listening to sermons, joining in fellowships, praying, reading the Bible, but perhaps the truest experience is in receiving his body. It is in partaking of his body that a true union occurs between Christ and his people. If this is true, we are faced with a dilemma today, where we are unable to partake of the body of Christ, unable to receive the sacrament that is so central to our faith. Yet, I would suggest that we still partake of the body of Christ, even through our current venues of worship, live streaming, Zoom, and others. We see the faces of our brothers and sisters in Christ, each person a sacramental expression of the body of Christ. Each face, in each and every face, we see the face of Jesus. Of course, we know that eventually, at journey's end, the Eucharist awaits us. For Clopas and the other disciple, Jesus journeyed with them on the road, and Jesus awaited them at the end of their journey. The same is true for us as we continue our journey with COVID-19. As we walk this road, Jesus is with us. And at the end of our journey, Jesus awaits. He is with us now and will be with us then. As Columba wrote, "The path I walk, Christ walks it. Well does the fair Lord show us a course and a path." Thanks be to God. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Let us say the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. We at St. James thank you for joining us for our Zoom service today. To stay up to date with your giving and pledging, please use this QR code before you. You will need to download a QR reader from the App Store on your phone if you don't already have it. And if you have any trouble with that, there is a link to our online donation site in front of you as well. Continued support during this time of the virus helps us stay current in our church operations and ministry here in Bozeman, the diocese, the nation, and the world. Please remember this is the fourth Sunday of the month, so it is CWC Sunday. I would ask that if you this week make out checks to the church that you in the memo line please write CWC. If it is possible to note your gift otherwise through the donor box and such for CWC, please do so. If not, the money will go to your pledges. Please note something too. This is very important to me. It's important to all of us, I think. Our bringing this service to you, our bringing the prayer services to you, everything we're able to do on the internet is at the very, very, very least, in part, a big part to Connie. And we're so thankful and grateful to her. And I ask that you would keep her in your prayers, that you would be mindful of the fact that she has worked hours and hours and hours to make all of this possible. And Connie, we thank you. We thank you. And I also want to thank Breezy, who too has given of herself to help us with these services. And without her, things would not be running as smoothly as they are. So please keep Connie and Breezy in your thoughts and prayers as they continue to serve the church well. Many of you will have already read my pastoral letter concerning our response to COVID-19. You're aware of the fact that the bishop set a while ago the date of May 10th as the earliest date we could begin worship again in person. She is holding to that and has advised clergy to do the same. So May 10th will be the earliest that we begin again. In the diocese, amongst the clergy of the larger churches like St. James, we have discussed this, and it is doubtful that we will begin that early. But we are staying on top of it. I have formed a response task force that will be working vigorously to come up with plans for reopening, and we will keep you posted along the way. Believe me, we want to be back together. But above and beyond that, the most important thing to me and the rest of the staff and the leadership of St. James is your well-being and caring for you as members of the body of Christ. We want you taken care of, and that's our priority. And please rest in that, rest secure in that. We love you. Okay, Breezy, I believe I'm to turn it over to you.
Actually, no, I'm going to show what folks are up to these days.
Oh, I'm so sorry, Connie, and you told me to do that.
That's quite all right.
Mea culpa.
All right, we'll try this now. Let's see what people are doing. This is Amy and Ray. Amy's knitting for the craft fair, and Ray is crafting faith boxes. The Fosdall family is busy. Kitty and her family take picnics up on Picnic Hill, and Griffin, it looks like, is studying in his office closet. Scott Fosdall is fighting fires, and Griffin and Kitty are playing in the mud. By the way, Griffin was our main reader for Canticle 13. Thank you, Fosdalls. Here's a fun one. Linda giving Ron Hoseth a haircut. Let's see if I can get the... There we go.
We're going to start out this way. We'll shave a little bit off here. here.
Oh boy! Oh,
we have a mishap. We are losing the bowl.
Keep the bowl. Okay.
Sorry.
All right, this is what happens when the...
How much is this?
The salons are closed.
So how's your day, Ron Hossa?
Pretty
what
good.
Been up to?
How
are the wife? How are the wife and kids here,
I just want a little touch-up.
A little touch-up.
Well, I don't know. We'll see what happens. You got a lot of hair going on. This might cost you a little more.
Yeah. Just want the gray ones.
Here we are.
This is what we do.
Okay.
Oh, here's a good one. Randy, Addison, Adric, Aubrey, all caring for their bees. Isn't that a great picture? Now, Keith, you'll have to ask Keith more about this. I think what he said to me, that he converted 1,837 cassettes into digital files so he can listen to his high school music on his phone. He's happy camper. Judy Tsang tried her hand at making masks. We have Patty Coles and her daughter Kalani with Melly, their dog, at their piece of heaven in the mountains at their cabin near the Boulder River. Melinda Benoit is making progress on this pile of junk. But her cleaning up of her storage closet. And finally, we have Ridley and Ross Brandemere fishing. Now, this is gorgeous, so you'll have to watch this. So don't forget, if you have a fun selfie or a 30-second video of what you've been doing that you'd like to share, send it to me and we'll post it next week.
Thank you, Connie.
All right, now we will head to our breakout room. So I'm going to unmute everybody right now, and then a prompt will come up on your screen to join a little mini chat room so that we can share the piece with everyone. So I'm unmuting everybody, and here we go.
Hi.
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 Hey, how are you? How are you?
Good.
Are you in? Hi, Ty. Hello. Join break. I guess we have to.
Hey, Susie.
All right, we're here now?
Yes.
Hi, Ty.
Hey, John.
Good to see your face.
You too.
Are you still working at the hardware store?
No.
I'm sorry.
I moved to Sprint at Bozeman. Sprint at Bozeman, John.
Spring at Bozeman.
Yes.
Huh. I'll have to look that up. I hope it's a good job.
How did he kill Amelded?
Peace be with everyone.
You too.
Peace to all. Vicki, it's hard to believe that you're sitting there enjoying yourself and not with a microphone in your hand. Telling Clark what to do.
Oh, gosh. Maudie, you are still muted.
All right.
Wonderful. There's just about a minute left for the breakout rooms. If you didn't get assigned to one, I just usually assume that like those who don't get assigned just make their own here in the main chat. So just so you know. It always takes everybody a long time to get back.
Hello, Hugh. It's good to see you.
Hey, we joined another group?
No, you're back in the main group now.
Oh, okay.
Are you going to mute us all, Breezy?
You know what? I'm going to mute everybody, and then I'll unmute the people.
That you want to hear
here we us? Go. Everyone's being muted.
The host has muted us. Okay.
Well, you just unmuted us. Go down. Yeah. There you go.
And it's not because we don't want to talk to everybody, of course.
So, Breezy, will you let me know when I'm ready to begin again?
Yes. We have just a couple people making their way back, so I would just give it like 10 more seconds and then.
All right.
Good to go, Rax.
The Lord be with you and also with you.
With you.
Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
Help us, O God, our Savior.
Deliver us and forgive us our sins.
Look upon your congregation.
Give to your people the blessing of peace.
Declare your glory among the nations.
And your wonders among all peoples.
Do not let the oppressed be ashamed and turned away.
Never forget the lives of your poor.
Continue your loving kindness to those who know you.
And your favor to those who are true of heart.
Satisfy us by your loving kindness in the morning.
So shall we rejoice and be glad all the days of our lives.
Let us pray. O God, whose blessed Son made himself known to his disciples in the breaking of bread, open the eyes of our faith that we may behold him in all his redeeming work, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Join me in the prayers of the people. If you have your prayer book, I'm using the prayers on page 387. Please stay muted, however, so that there's no confusion. Father, we pray for your holy Catholic Church that we all may be one. Grant that every member of the church may truly and humbly serve you, that your name may be glorified by all people. We pray for all bishops, priests, and deacons, and this morning we pray for Michael, our presiding bishop, Marty, our bishop, our entire staff of clergy, and all the faithful ministers of your word and sacraments. We pray for all who govern and hold authority in the nations of the world, that there may be justice and peace on the earth. and give us grace to do your will in all that we undertake, that our works may find favor in your sight. Have compassion on those who suffer from any grief or trouble. And Lord, we take a moment now to silently offer their names to you. We lift up all those who are recovering from COVID-19. We lift up all those who may contract it. We lift up all those who are in the hospital and they're alone there because nobody can get in. So those who are alone without their loved ones around them in this very difficult time of illness. We pray for all those who are in any kind of trouble or adversity. We pray for all those who seek you. And may they find you as the great physician and healer. Lord, we pray that they may be delivered from their distress. And give to the departed eternal rest. And Lord, I lift up Vern Klingensmith, who died 11 years ago today. I thank Father Clark for being there with us at 2:00 in the morning. I thank you for all those who have died, who have crossed our paths. May we remember them. And should there be any anxiety, resentment, negativity around those memories, help to lift them from us, Lord. That what we are remaining with is memories of love and Lord, we pray that light perpetual shine upon them. And we praise you for your saints, all your saints who have entered into joy. May we also come to share in your heavenly kingdom. And let us pray for our own needs and those of others. O Lord, our God, accept the fervent prayers of all of us, all of your people. In the multitude of your mercies, look with compassion upon us and all who turn to you for help. For you are gracious, O lover of souls. And to you we give glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen.
Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplication to you. And you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will be in the midst of them. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen.
Let us bless the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia. Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
May the God of hope fill us with all joy and peace in believing through the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
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 Thank you for being with us this morning. Thank you so very much. We all pray in the name of our Lord Jesus that your day, your week will be blessed immensely. Please keep in mind that if you ever have any needs that we might be able to help with, don't hesitate to call us. Please don't hesitate to call us.
If you want to stay on the line for just a minute afterwards, after the postlude, just stay for coffee hour, virtual coffee hour. All right.
Thank you.
Well, wow.
Very
thank
good.
You. Thank you for all the technology this morning. Thank you, everyone, for being here this morning. It is so wonderful to see you. And I can tell you that we're missing all of you very, very, very much. And so it's wonderful to see you. I hope you grabbed your cup of coffee. And if anybody wants to say anything, say it.
Yes, you're all muted. Hi, everybody.
Thank
Hi,
you.
Mario. Hi, Bill. Hi, Dee.
Hi.
Hey. Hey, Jerry, what did you think of that?
Hi. Lovely to see Margo.
Yeah. Hi, Thurza.
Far away.
And Dee Carter. Dee Carter is on.
Yeah, Dee. Let's hold hands.
Hey, everybody, go to the gallery view so you can see everybody that's on the screen.
And then there's an arrow on the right hand side, and you can keep flipping.
Hi, Heidi.
Hi, Marty.
Hi, Heidi.
There's Patty.
Oh my God.
Oh my gosh. Heidi, Beth Townsend, thank you so much for being with us all the time. The Roxy and Connie prayer services. Thank you so much.
You know, Roxy, I want to know, have the Rutherfords ever gotten stung by those bees?
Roxy, one of the great advantages of having this all virtual is that on the breaks, I don't have to drink the coffee that Father Greg makes.
Yeah, there you go.
Whoops.
That's probably good. We might have a discussion about the good things about virtual church. Anybody want to offer anything about virtual church?
Well, something that's lovely is seeing Margo so far away. We can still see her.
Thurza.
There are two people that we haven't seen in a long while that are here.
Thurza.
I'm unmuting me. Where is it? Here
you're unmuted, Thurza.
Hi, Margo.
Something I learned from my daughter, Laura, when they pray the Lord's Prayer at some of her meetings, people put their hands out to touch whatever machine they're using to see. And that kind of makes a connection.
Yeah.
Love it. I did that for the Lord's Prayer today, but I just want to let you know it's something, and I'm doing it right now because I just love being with all of you. Thanks.
How about anybody else? Anybody else want to comment about virtual church?
Chris Candle is doing something.
Hi,
Chris.
Hi. It's nice to see people that go to different services because I haven't met everyone being a new person. So it's very
Chris,
nice.
I miss you so much. I miss seeing you. So I'm so glad to see you now.
Okay. Well, good to see you.
Boy, the background is beautiful.
Yes. Well, Cheryl, you finally came to church, I see.
Oh, yes. I'm dragging along late and I put tape over the camera so nobody can see me. You're very beige. I wanted to join you though.
That looked like duct tape. The other side of duct tape. Yeah.
I would love to know if anybody is sitting in front of the camera with bunny slippers on. Anybody with bunny slippers?
Flip flops.
But I have, okay. I have big blue slippers.
I'm barefoot.
Barefoot. I'm barefoot.
Hi, kids. Hi, kids.
Still up at the cabin? Patty, are you still up at the cabin?
No, I came home Friday. The snow was getting pretty thin.
Where's Patty?
And I was worried about having to walk out. But I did snowmobile, but we hit a lot of dirt and a lot of rocks.
Oh.
Hi, Bill Dennis.
Hello. How are you?
Good morning.
Judy Farrington, morning. I'm reading your chat message. Dana. And I would certainly consult Father Clark with that, about that. But certainly there's going to be a lot of discussion around communion and how it may happen. And so thank you for your note in the chat. It certainly is worth putting into the conversation as the task force gets together. So thank you for that.
It was nice singing familiar songs during the service today.
Hi. I talked to the Baileys this week. Nice to see you again.
Yeah. Somebody's
wolfing. Oh, Bill McGinnis got dressed up for church.
Well,
look, Carol put her best face on.
It's good you don't see my pants. I still have my pajama pants on, just a good shirt.
Okay.
Do I have that blank look?
We're awfully glad to have South Carolina and Florida with us this morning. I'm wondering if we have any other states with us this morning. Any others?
Who's in Florida?
Me.
Me, me, Carter.
Florida, okay.
Yep, and the McGinnises are in South Carolina. Okay. Fort Mill, is that right?
That's right.
Yep, all right, good.
And I see Holly Hunt and Leanne Ramey on the phone.
Yay.
You ladies doing? There.
Leanne Ramey is helping deliver pizzas on Sunday afternoon. This might be something you all might want to know. Bridger Brewing, which is owned by David Sigler and partners, have volunteered 12 pizzas on Sunday afternoon to those who need them. And so would you do me a favor, if you're hungry for a pizza, do a drive-by and get a pizza from Bridger Brewing, which, by the way, makes awfully good pizza. And thank David for his generosity. This is wonderful. And Lee Ann is taking care of rustling up people and also doing it herself to deliver the pizzas to those who really need them. So if you know of anybody that is on the edge, would probably appreciate something like this. We will do it safely, of course, but let us know and we'll get it to the team of volunteers that are really doing awesome work to take care of people who are in need. So thank you, Leanne.
Or she might want to start up now.
Yeah. Holly, do you want to say something? We'll let you, jump in, Holly, if you want to. We can't see you, but we know you're on the line with your phone.
Hi, Bob.
Is that Carol Howitt?
There I am.
Hi, Carol.
Where are you?
Here, in the corner.
Click on gallery view if you have your video on. Go to gallery view.
Hi, Carol.
Hi there, Dr. Clark.
Everybody well?
Everybody well. A little family situation in Pennsylvania we're trying to deal with, but a lot of prayer.
Our prayers are with you. Yeah.
Thank you.
Did we find Holly?
Yeah, well, she unmuted. I'm
here.
Oh!
I'm here.
Bing. Hey, Holly.
Met you. Glad to have you with us. How is it doing it on the phone?
It's good. It's good. I'm actually on my computer, but one of the things every Sunday morning, I'm like, do I want to have waffles and coffee and sleep in late or go to church? And now I can do both at the same time.
Good for you, Ms.
That's
the
good thing about virtual church, right?
Yeah.
We'll put that into our collection of what's good about virtual church.
I'm really grateful.
And coffee and church.
I'm really grateful.
I have a tutoring session coming up, everyone. I need to go. God bless. Be well. See you all.
Bye.
Breezy, you were going to say something?
Oh, I was just going to say, I'm so grateful that I'm able to conducting the choir. I'm just during services, I don't have as much opportunity to connect with the parish family. So I'm so grateful I'm getting to know so many amazing members of this community. So that's what I'm grateful for with the digital services.
Good.
Hey, Jerry, what did you think of that trout those boys were catching?
Oh, I just am so tickled for Ridley. I know that family well because they're swimmers. So yeah, that was nice.
That was an amazing video.
I had seen his video. Yeah.
And I really liked the music that went along with it. Oh, boy. It was good jazz. I'm going to call Emily and find out who that was that she put on that. Was
Where
terrific.
Were they fishing? Does anybody know?
It's a secret.
It's a secret.
Peggy, you don't ask a fisherman their
never
secret
tell.
Spot. Ew, deadly.
I saw Wendell Wilson put up a note saying that was a whitefish. It was not a trout.
Yes, that's what I heard too.
But there were both. Yes. It was nice.
Well, there's Ty. How are you, Mr. Ty Sherwood?
So, yeah. Sorry Ty. About that. Hi, my... Ty. Hi.
Hey, Ty.
Hi, Ty.
Hi, Ty.
Sorry about that.
You're okay. I saw you come on and go off, so you're good. Good to see you, Ty.
You too.
I have a celebration. Yesterday was my birthday.
Ah, happy birthday!
I got to see, it's going to make me cry. I got to see my three-year-old granddaughter and step-grandsons and my daughter-in-law and son for the first time in 2 months.
Oh, wow, fabulous. Oh, and
so I'm just so grateful, and I'm so grateful for all of you. I love it when I know the page that we're on when we're in the service. Sometimes I, or exactly what the reading, you know, the chapter and the verse, that's really helpful for me. And I'm just grateful for all of you. Thank you.
And don't forget that the whole service is printed out for you for the weekend, but we, because of you and Thirza, I'm going to give you both credit. Connie, when we do our little services, are very mindful of the fact that we need to make sure people know where we are. So thank you for that, because it's helpful. And sometimes we think, oh, well, we've got it nailed and we know exactly what we're doing, but because people are joining us and helping us do it even better, thank you both for very much for caring enough to let us know what we need to do better. Great. And I will put in a little plug. Noon and 5 p.m. Monday through Saturday, Connie and I are doing services. We've even been known to do it from the car on the way from home from the golf course. But still managing to do it.
So honest, Roxy.
And really, but it's so wonderful. So thank you for joining us again live on St. James Facebook, and less than 10 minutes usually a day. And we're doing a little way of love work right now, and stay tuned because it's really special. And we're kind of doing that at noon and maybe in the evening, but a little bit of way of love, Bishop Curry, and this wonderful series, if I can call it that. So may you all have really a blessed day, rest of the day. I see the sun out, and also an absolutely terrific week. And stay tuned. If you're in the right, you'll be getting a call from a clergy person this week. We love it. And we love you.
We love you.
We love you too.
Thank you.
Bye, everybody.
Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you.
Thank you, everybody. Miss everybody.
Yes.
Yes.
Good to see everybody well.
Bye, Cassie.
Bye, guys.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye, guys.
Goodbye.
Bye, everybody.
Bye, Monty.
Hey, Breezy, don't forget to turn off the recording. Carol.
Yes.
I wouldn't care seeing you just come out of bed.
Oh, no, I'm even dressed.
Take that tape off. There I am. Now we can see you. Leanne,
I need a
wonderful to talk to you, Leanne. Thanks for this afternoon.
Boy, and thank you for the call this week, Connie.
You're absolutely welcome.
Yeah. Are these services recorded? Could
yes,
I catch
they
up?
Are. They are. And I will send you the link. Go to YouTube.
Okay.
Just YouTube.com and search for St. James Bozeman. You have to put in Bozeman or you'll get a lot of different St. James's.
Okay. Yes, I will catch up with what I missed. Thank you.
All right.
Okay. I'm leaving now. Bye.
All right, bye. Bye, Ty.
Bye, Connie.
Good to see you.
You too.
Bye.